Hi everyone, I'm Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about equalization. A lot of people are confused about equalization. They think it's a cure-all to your room issues. It's really not. Let's talk about what EQ actually is. EQ is electronically adjusting the music, the source, to fit the room. I mean, that's really what we're doing if you think about it. We have too much bass in the recording. We have too much of this or too much less of that, so we're going to add or subtract energy from the original recording in order to fit into our room a little bit better. This works works okay for low frequencies, but middle and high frequencies not so well. So we have to be really careful. We should try to get the room to fit the music source. I mean, let's work acoustically with the room and try and solve the issues that the room presents so we don't have to add too much EQ. Unfortunately, in today's smaller rooms, low frequency EQ is good in some cases and not so good in other cases, but the low frequency area can benefit from EQ, but our middles and highs we have to be careful of. We also watch room residences or nulls. These are areas where boosting EQ to fill a null or a void can be a little bit dangerous. We don't want to keep adding energy into a null through EQ because it'll just keep getting swallowed up by the room anyway. So we're really kind of defeating the purpose here. Comb filter reflections, we have to be very careful with that. Adding EQ to that situation can definitely make it worse. And we don't want to keep increasing energy into an area that the room can't handle because we'll just overtax our electronics and possibly blow a driver. So we want to be very careful with that. EQing a room to a flat response. I hear this a lot. This is not how we hear. This is not normal human hearing. Music is not perfectly flat. We want to be careful about EQing to a flat response because it's not natural. It's not normal. So use your EQ subtly and do a little bit of EQ, do a little bit of listening. You know, it's an evaluation process, and it a little bit, parts of the EQ system will work in your room and parts of it may not, mainly the low frequency area. We also have to remember that most of the energy above 500 cycles is caused from our speaker. So we want to be very concerned about our speaker, and anything below 500 cycles is the energy and the what we hear is caused by our room. So we want to be very careful with EQ. It's a process that can't do it all. The algorithms in most EQ programs can't do it all. The room is still a very, very important factor, and I would argue, and a lot of people in the acoustics industry will argue, the most important factor. Thank you.